untuk soalan lain ni.
Boleh. Saya berdiri kat sini kan. Jadi tanyalah.
Dengan declaration of asset. Ah. Ini supposed to be the last day. Right? So yeah. Has the opposition declared your assets?
So I think we close the submission at 5 o'clock today. I had been informed that as at today at 5 p.m., 160 MP had submitted. 160 out of 222, right? My record show that all the Pakatan Harapan MP have declared their assets, declarations to the Dewan Speaker with a copy to be given to the SPRM. Yeah, don't get confused. Yeah, this declaration is made to the Dewan Speaker with a copy to be given to the SPRM. Yeah, okay. Because this is in pursuant to the usul, usul yang kita buat pada bulan bulan Julai yang lalu.
And all the 160 is from the government.
No, you have to. Government MP hanya 138, right? Meaning to say that the balance, which is 22, come from GPS, come from PAS, and then I think the record also shows that there is one or two from Barisan Nasional that had filed their, okay, I'll give it to you lah. Okay, daripada Pakatan Harapan semua telah pun file and submitted the asset declaration to the Dewan Speaker. Daripada BN UMNO, dua orang. Dari BN MCA, seorang. GPS PBB, 11. GPS PRS, 2. GPS SUPP, 1. GPS BDP, 1. PSB, 1. PBRS, 1. PBS, 1. So,
from UMNO and MCA,
hanya tiga orang saja.
Ada nama tak?
Saya tak boleh kasih tahu lah.
So, how about the rest? Adakah action beri-beri perlanjut termasuk ataupun tindakan?
Sekiranya mereka telah pun memohon dah untuk mengadakan pelanjutan masa kepada pihak speaker, bolehlah. Saya rasa itu terpulang kepada pihak speaker untuk memberikan panjangan masa kepada mereka. It's up to the speaker.
Maksudnya right? Mereka boleh mohon kepada speaker tapi speaker akan pertimbang.
Kenalah pohon hari ini. Tak kena esok. Esok. Today is already the last day.
Okay, so for those who tak mohon and tak declare, before this you said action will be taken.
Yes, of course.
What kind of action?
I already said it lah, contempt of the house. Because this is a usul daripada dewan, ya. Jadi mereka tidak menghormati usul ini. Jadi ini menjadikan satu perkara yang menghinakan dewan yang mulia ini. Okey, usul ini telah pun diluluskan oleh ahli-ahli yang berhormat dalam dewan juga. So they should know that the implication for not complying with the usul. Okay.